some of this in here.
Mm-hmm.
Got a blueberry here. We're gonna put a strawberry.
Mm-hmm. That's how you do it.
Cannibal style.
Yep. You ready?
There we go.
Okay.
Oh my God.
Mm.
That beautiful crunch. Hey, what's up? It's Luis with America's Best Restaurants. We travel the country coast to coast to find the places where you need to eat at on a weekly basis. And today we are in Knoxville, Tennessee at a very, very special restaurant for me. This was founded by an incredible woman whose life got shattered into a million pieces. But then she picked herself back up and now has an incredible restaurant with a gigantic connection to the community, which proves that sometimes you have to take a leap of faith. This is Water Into Wine Bistro and Lounge. Let's go check it out.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Hi.
I am so excited to be here.
Thank you.
I've been talking about this place since ever since you and I spoke originally on the phone.
Nice.
And I can't wait. Number one, when I walked in, I didn't know what to expect. This is gorgeous.
Good.
So I don't know how you did it, but you did an amazing job.
Thank you.
This place is unbelievable. It's got this really super kind of chill vibe.
Yes.
But it's a little cozy. It's gorgeous. I like the wood accents. This bar is gorgeous.
Thank you.
Look at the backdrop. It looks amazing.
Thank you.
It looks absolutely amazing. And I see you got, I mean, I don't even want to eat this because it looks so beautiful.
Yes.
So what do we have here?
Well, you eat with your eyes first.
That is correct.
So this is brulee brie.
Okay.
And we use a triple cream brie.
Okay.
We candy all our own nuts.
Wow.
We get fresh fruits and vegetables every day.
Okay.
We make our own crostinis. So yeah,
really?
It's pretty scratch
okay.
from beginning. And
so what do I do this? Do I just kind of,
you can
I
do
don't
that.
Destroying it?
Usually people okay. take the bread.
Oh.
And they'll just dip it in.
Rookie move, Louise. Good job.
And then they'll use the spoon
okay.
and kind of scoop
oh,
it on.
Okay.
Right?
Gotcha.
And then they'll okay. usually put like a strawberry on.
Okay, so let me get some of this in here.
Mm-hmm.
Got a blueberry here. We're going to put a strawberry.
Mm-hmm. That's how you
cannibal
do it.
Cannibal style.
Yep. You ready?
There we go.
Okay.
Oh my God.
Mm.
That beautiful crunch.
Mm-hmm.
That brie is insane. Insane. It's got the little saltiness, nice and creamy.
Thank you.
The strawberry and just the candied nuts, they give it a really, really great texture.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my God.
Good.
I've never had this anywhere else. This is outstanding.
Thank you.
Wow. If this is how we're starting,
mm-hmm.
I might just have to stay the night. I'm just saying that. What is this drink that we have here?
This is our house-made sangria.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So what do we have?
Enjoy a taste of that. Hey, Sierra, can you come here for a moment?
Oh, wow. Super refreshing.
He's asking about the sangria. Why don't you explain to him what's in it and how you made it?
So
go ahead and get closer.
It's in a wine glass.
Okay.
It's just, peach schnapps as
okay.
a little bit of lemon and lime juice. And then we add a little bit of a sweetener to it, some agave. And some orange juice and some
okay.
red wine.
Okay, this is fantastic. Super refreshing.
Yeah,
super refreshing.
It's
great.
Nice summer day. It's super light.
Yeah, absolutely. Mm. That is phenomenal.
Thank you, Sierra.
So Candace, I am actually going to eat all of this off
Yay.
Camera.
Okay.
That is phenomenal. I've never had anything like it before. Now, do we have an opportunity? We can jump in the kitchen, go meet chef.
Yo,
go
yeah.
prepare a dish.
I okay. would love for you to do that.
Fantastic. So that's coming up next. Awesome. So now we are in the kitchen with Chef Eric. So Chef, what are we making today?
Today we are going to be doing a sesame seared ahi tuna, serving it with all the traditional fixings
okay.
and our house-made Asian slaw as well.
All right. Fantastic. So I'll let you take it over. Where we start,
All
Chef?
Right. We're going to start out right now first by getting our nice sriracha on
okay.
the plate.
All right.
Making everything look beautiful is one of our trademarks here at this establishment.
That's awesome.
Because we all know the food's gonna taste good when it looks good.
This is when you know it's legit. He's got a special tool to do this. That's awesome. That is fantastic. So, you, Chef, originally, did you work in a lot of five-star dining restaurants?
I've just kind of been different places. I don't like not knowing how to do stuff.
Okay.
So I try to take the time to learn as much as I can and learn to execute. And it's just kept me happy with my passion and making beautiful food for everybody. And that's what it's all about.
That makes sense. So, Chef, School of Hard Knocks or Culinary School?
School of Hard Knocks, always. That's my preference.
Okay, awesome.
Chef Adam, can you hand me a thing of rice whenever you get a second, please, and thank you.
All right.
Wonderful.
Awesome, okay, so what are we gonna do?
Now we have our nice, this is our cilantro lime rice.
Okay.
So what I'd like to do, I take this and I build a little wall on the back end, give a nice little base for our ahi tuna to sit on. And it's okay if it is at a room temperature because that tuna is served cold.
Right,
so we don't want it to cook up, you know, much at all.
Okay.
Get a little glove change real quick.
Yes, Chef.
And now the next step we're gonna be doing, we're gonna be taking our wasabi.
Fries are up.
Always. Taking our wasabi, doing a nice little smear here, and then I'm gonna be bringing out the tuna for you guys.
Yes, Chef.
Getting it put on plate. Go ahead. And all of our sauces that we do with this are made in-house, fresh.
Really? Here, from scratch?
Yes, sir.
Oh my God.
Yes, sir.
This kitchen is very, very small, so I apologize for the room that we're taking, but we're filming this content because I wanted to get this direct here because this looks incredible.
All right. We'll slide this back.
Okay, all right.
These are our beautiful
seared
ahi tuna fillets. We do these in-house also.
Okay.
And
so you sear them lightly, then you do you sear them with
I sear them with the sesame seeds, sir. It gets a nice little coating on it, but crisps the seeds up, and you get that nice sesame flavor locked into your fish as well.
Is there anything else that you season it with, Chef?
No, sir.
Okay, just the sesame seeds,
yes,
nice
sir.
And clean. Okay,
we like to cut these on a little corner bias.
Okay, nice. Oh my God, look at that color. Oh wow, oh wow. Okay.
Then we will start our placement.
Oh, so it comes with more than one.
Yes, sir. Three pieces is your... Yes, sir. That's why this could be done appetizer style or an entree style, just depending on how hungry you are or what you may want to have and take home with you later after your meal.
So basically what you're telling me is that other restaurants are basically skimpy.
They could be. Okay. They could be. Yeah, we care about our guests and we want them to come back. So we want to make sure they get their money's worth and they enjoy everything that they get.
You're like Santa Claus right now. I want you to know this.
All right.
Oh my gosh. Okay. What else we got going on?
Next, we have our in-house made wasabi paste.
How long does it take to make this?
To make this, we can have it out in about 5 to 7 minutes.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
We've done it enough times to where we have a nice little plan of execution.
Wow.
So I'm actually going to turn this around this way to where you guys are able to see this a little bit better while we're doing it.
Oh my
And we just take a nice little...
So nothing store-bought. Everything. I mean, even the wasabi's made in-house. That's crazy. Oh my gosh.
Give them a nice dollop of that right there.
Okay.
Then we will go to our Asian slaw here.
Oh my, wow, so this dish never ends.
No, sir.
Okay.
This is another, just another little implement to get some color in the dish, make everything pop. This is seasoned in rice wine vinegar and a little bit of sesame oil just to complement the fish.
That looks outstanding. Wow.
And from here,
okay,
we go to our delicious in-house yum yum sauce that we make.
Wow. Okay.
It is fantastic. Everyone seems to
Look at that color. Oh wow.
They always ask for extra sides of it when we put it out. Yes, sir. And that's what we want here. That's keeps them coming back. They find something they like, but also they're gonna keep, you know, spending a little extra money with us. Okay. And you know, at the end of the day, if you're doing what you're supposed to be doing, product and presentation wise, money's gonna come, and it's not a big thing at all if this is what, you know, what we want to do and what we care about.
And then you got some scallions going on here.
Yes, sir. Fresh cut, sharp bias scallions.
Wow. So for the people watching, scallions, that's another word for green onion. Okay.
Yeah.
Love that.
These are my favorite.
Oh my
great
God. I love
soups.
Love it.
Can never ever get enough of them.
I put this stuff on pasta. I put it on everything.
Exactly.
On everything.
Exactly.
It's a great garnish.
It is. And now for our finishing touch, we are just.
More?
Last thing, you gotta have the soy. You gotta have soy ginger.
As if we didn't do it.
Yes, sir. You gotta have the soy sauce and a little bit of ginger. So we just take our little small ram, get it filled up.
Wow. Okay.
We like to place that guy right about there.
Oh my God.
And then we have our pickled ginger.
Hey, there's more to this? Wow. Okay.
When I say we do it with all the fixings, we...
Yes, Chef.
We definitely okay. do.
All right.
Get our nice little twist.
Wow.
And there we have wow. our completed ahi tuna.
Oh my God.
Dish.
Look at this. Oh my gosh. Chef, if you don't mind, I will step out of the kitchen to
yes,
give you
sir.
Back your own, because I know this is pretty small here, and I'll try it out there. Is that okay
that
with you, Chef?
That is perfectly okay.
Fantastic. Thank you so much. So that's coming up next. I can't wait to the end of this. All right, everybody. So we are out here. I'm actually talking to some of the locals because the kitchen was a little cramped. So why not share, right? So who do we have here?
Hi, I'm Karen Schaefer.
Okay,
and
awesome.
I'm a transplant from Binghamton, New York. Met Candace in this restaurant in early 2018. Candace refers to me as her mom from Jesus.
Oh, awesome.
And I help her with her bookkeeping.
Love it, and love it.
She's been, I'll cry, she's been my heart.
I love it. That's awesome. That is awesome. Especially when you connect with people.
Oh, yeah.
Love that.
Yeah.
Love that. What's your name?
My name is Victoria Boyle. We've been coming here since she opened
yep.
about. So we've come to all the anniversary parties.
Okay.
It's our local. We have so many friends here.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
That's awesome. And you, sir?
So I'm the husband, Michael Boyle.
Okay.
The accent's not local.
Right.
But I really love coming down here.
I love it.
Yeah, we've got a lot of friends here. Love the food, love the variety of wines that she's got.
How many years have you been coming here?
So since it opened, that's
okay.
been close to 7 years.
Okay, okay.
Yep.
Fantastic.
I'm a newer one. I just came in here in 2018.
Gotcha, gotcha. Have you tried this dish, the ahi tuna?
I have not.
I have not either.
But I'm excited to try it.
Have you tried it?
Oh yeah, I'm the
okay,
favorite.
Okay, I got
it's
you.
My favorite.
Okay, okay. Now, yeah. this is your favorite. What about yours? What is your favorite?
The Italian flat's my favorite.
Okay, mm-hmm. all right.
Yeah, I have that a lot. And the appetizers are always good. The mushrooms,
okay.
the dippity-do.
Okay.
Different little options on yeah. it, so it's really good too.
What about you?
I'm a fan of the soups and the charcuterie boards.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
and so, yeah. I don't eat a lot of food per se.
Okay.
Long story, but
okay.
anyway, I love the soups.
Okay, are we ready to try this?
Sure.
Okay, well, however you want to do it. I'm going to go cannibal style, like I said. Go ahead. Please go ahead.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Perfect.
Some of that was wasabi.
I see what you're doing. I see what he's doing.
And the ginger.
Mm-hmm.
Nope, not the
All
ginger
right.
for me.
I'm going to go, like I said, cannibal
stuff.
Style. So
I'm
let me put this
here.
Okay, here we go.
Thank you, darling.
You're welcome.
Oh, my white pants.
A little bit of wasabi on there.
Anybody want the soy?
Oh, my gosh. Wow.
Looks delicious, doesn't it?
I mean, look at that.
We're about to see.
Look at the color on that.
I'm going to get all the yum yum.
Yeah.
It's hard for me to describe what ahi tuna tastes like, but with that sauce, that yum yum sauce,
mm-hmm.
it's outstanding. You get a little bit of that crunch from those sesame
mm-hmm.
seeds. It's outstanding. What do you think?
It's fantastic.
And you haven't had it before, right?
No. It's really good. Mm. I have not had it. Actually, he gets it everywhere we go, and I rarely get it.
Really?
So I'm like, okay, this is really good. I will have to start
This is outstanding.
Mm-hmm.
It's outstanding.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Like I said, it's difficult. Unless you've had ahi tuna before, it's difficult for me to explain it.
Mm-hmm.
But it's got a really, really nice crunch, nice sesame taste on the outside. Mm-hmm. It's dense. It's outstanding, honestly.
Very good.
Honestly. So is this one dish that you're going to be getting from now moving forward?
Definitely.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I'll have to.
One of the most popular dishes here is the salmon.
Okay.
It's very, very popular. We use it in tacos, we have it on salads.
Okay. Fantastic.
Yeah.
So tell me a little bit about your connection with the community, with this restaurant.
So my husband and I lived in the same house in Oak Ridge, which is about 20 miles from here, for 30 years.
Oh, wow.
Old house was declining, and more the responsibility of the house belonged with me. So we downsized, we moved to Farragut, which is like 3 miles from here.
Okay.
We went to Melville Mushroom, which is down the strip mall from
mm-hmm.
here, had the worst pizza ever, walked into this joint, I mean this restaurant,
okay.
I mean joint.
You're good.
And we never left.
Mm-hmm.
So his health declined and he passed away in October 21.
Sorry to hear that.
This is my family. Because I have family here. But this water and wine is family.
I love it. I love it. That's awesome. It's difficult to find that community, but once you find it, you never want to leave it.
Right.
No, I'm here every day because this is my family. But, you know, living alone. Okay, just had to put makeup on and I'm going to cry.
Yeah, we're all really close. We've been to her daughter's wedding. She's been to my daughter's wedding. You know, we do so many activities together, summer activities. And she's involved in the community a lot, does a lot with the community. And we always support her for that.
So another thing, Katniss does off-site events.
Yeah.
And I went and got my ABC so I can serve alcohol legally in the state of Tennessee.
Right.
So Katniss and I do that.
That's cool.
It's really cool. It's really cool.
That's awesome. Well, I really, really appreciate spending a little bit of time with you, trying out this awesome food. Hey, we try some new things that you like now.
That's right.
Right? So now you have more choices as well as you. So that's fantastic. Again, I really, really appreciate it. And now coming up, we have another amazing dish. All right, everybody. So now we're gonna get to find out Candace's story. But first, let's start with this. So this is a cocktail they made. I know you didn't even know the name. It's all good. This is called the Punch Out, right?
Yeah.
Or Peach Out.
Peach One Out. Peach out. Out.
It's like a milk punch. So, wow, that's really good. You guys have your drinks here?
Well, we make everything from scratch. So our bitters, we use the Bitter Gay Company, and that was Kevin, who was our manager and mixologist. He and his husband moved to Ohio, and he started his own bitter company. So all of his bitters that Knoxville fell in love with, now we make all of his cocktails with his stuff.
That's fantastic. The drinks that I've had here are outstanding.
Good.
Even my field producer, Austin, had an old-fashioned, smoked old-fashioned. He's like, oh my God, that was an unbelievable drink. He stopped drinking it because he's still filming.
You want to grab that? That's the key to these amazing cocktails. Yeah.
All right. Awesome.
That's fun.
All righty. Fantastic. And we have two incredible dishes here. So let's start with this one.
Okay.
This is the Chilean sea bass. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay.
So we are tapas, in that we've got all kinds of fun things that groups can share.
Okay.
But we also have a plates section.
Okay.
And that's what you and I are getting ready to enjoy.
Okay.
They're just larger quantity amounts, but everything's still baked, so it's not fried.
Right.
So it's not gonna make your have to do 400 sit-ups tomorrow.
Well, I mean, you don't even have a fryer in the kitchen.
Everything's baked.
The kitchen is incredibly small,
but
what they're putting out of the kitchen is outstanding.
Thank you.
It is outstanding.
Thank you.
So you're going to try this with me, right? Or did you already try it?
I've already tried it, but I'll do it again.
But this is a special. So this is not here all the time.
So Chef has a special every single night.
Every night?
Every night.
Oh, so it's not a weekly special.
It's not a weekly. No. Oh, every night. So we will run the Chilean sea bass till we run out of Chilean sea bass. Usually it's sold out within 48 hours. Two shifts is about where our specials last. And then he'll come up with something next.
That is
amazing, right? Yeah.
I mean, it's a
perfect sear.
Oh, it is. It's a little bit of a denser fish. People call it meaty. And then it's got, this is one thing that you're not gonna see all the time. Mm-hmm. So these right here are called truffles. These are not cheap.
No.
But they provide incredible, incredible flavor.
Mm-hmm.
What is this sauce underneath?
I thought you asked Chef.
I thought I did. But you know what? My bad.
Yeah. Yummy. Can I just say it's good?
And those mushrooms, it's outstanding. This is just absolutely unbelievable.
White wine, almost a bechamel.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah.
Is it beurre blanc? Okay.
It's a beurre blanc sauce.
There you go.
Okay, so there you go. Somebody yelled off camera. Appreciate it. Thank you so much. This is outstanding. It's a nice, denser fish, but it's a perfect sear, like you said.
Yep.
Made in the oven, so it's not heavy, but it's dense, if that makes any sense.
Yeah.
Perfectly salted. It's outstanding. This is an outstanding dish.
Thank you.
Oh my gosh. Wow. Wow. Mm. I'm gonna eat all that. I already know I'm gonna eat it. The mushrooms are ridiculously good. That Bel Blanc sauce is outstanding. Wow. This is a home run of a dish.
Thank you.
Then again, everything we've had here is a home run. So I'm not surprised that we have a couple different wines here. We got some white wine here. I don't even know what this is, but it's amazing. That's so good. And then we have this red.
Mm-hmm.
Red is for the tenderloin?
That's for the tenderloin, okay. Yes.
So, please, try
some. You ready?
Some. Okay, so we're gonna try some tenderloin. And
what, so, go ahead.
No, please, go ahead.
No, it's the, what makes this so fun, mm-hmm. So it's perfectly cooked, yes, medium rare. If you order medium well at my restaurant, you're probably gonna get a little smile. But okay. It's just sad. It's sad to the cow.
Right.
And then this is the blackberry reduction.
Okay.
All right. You're gonna wanna try that. So
let me try
because that red wine and blackberry.
Beautiful color.
Yes. And so we change the sauce on the filet medallions with every season. So our menu.
Wow.
Isn't that fun?
I've never had steak or any kind of meat with a blackberry sauce.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know what to expect when I read it on the menu. I'm like, okay, I'll give it a shot. That is something very different.
Good.
I love it. It's got the goat cheese, so it gives mm-hmm. it yep. a little richness. Mm-hmm. Oh my God. Mm. That is a dish.
So these are on our menu all the time.
Okay.
The only thing that changes would be the sauce every season. So I'm not sure what we're gonna do
okay.
for summer. Maybe a red wine reduction. We do all kinds of fun things.
Okay.
But this is our number one selling dish. This and our Norwegian salmon.
Okay.
Yeah, Norwegian salmon.
That is outstanding. Yeah. And I mean, that sauce, I'm a huge fan of that sauce now. Now I'm trying to process in my brain how I'm going to have this type of dish without a sauce like that. Mm-hmm. And I would have never thought that blackberry, okay. And with the goat cheese, it's absolutely outstanding. And that steak, perfectly cooked. Medium rare is the way to go.
Yep.
That's just me.
It's yummy.
Candace, I want to get into your story.
Okay.
Because I know a lot about it, but maybe not everybody watching does.
Okay.
You went through a lot of trial and tribulations, and I'm just being very nice by saying this, right? So let's get into it. I know originally you were adopted, yes?
Yes.
Okay. You grew up in California.
Yes.
All right. So tell me a little bit more about that. How did you develop and how your story came to be? Because I know it, but I don't want to tell it for you.
No,
I don't think it's right.
Fine. Well, I grew up, I was a product of a birth mother who unfortunately, through circumstance, became pregnant in 75 and went to California. At the time, abortion was not legal in Louisiana, but it was in California. And I didn't know quite all of the story till I found my birth family.
Oh,
but my birth mother told me that she did not want to have an abortion, even though her family wanted her to. Mm-hmm. So she decided to have me and put me up for adoption.
Okay.
And at that point, my adopted parents were able to give me a chance at life. That's I was awesome. Raised in a very strong Christian home, lots of love, only child. Some of my friends say spoiled brat, whatever, it's all good. But God was always just the center of our home. And then, I don't know if anybody remembers this, but in 1992 was the Rodney King beatings yes. of California. So my parents said at that point, I was in April, and my parents said, we are getting you out of this state. They knew that if I stayed in California, that I would get married, have babies, and I would never leave California because I love California and I love the beaches. And I grew up in Orange County and Huntington Beach was my pier. I had a wonderful childhood, Yosemite, it's all good. And then we moved to Tennessee. And I had to come to a realization that I'm in Knoxville. And so, sadly, this is my senior year of high school.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
You get on the block.
Oh, and I definitely did not enjoy Tennessee at all.
It's a big change.
Oh, crazy change. Crazy change. Okay. Like, there's no curbs in Tennessee. In California, the roads are straight, right? Okay. So, you know, I'll never forget. I hadn't been here a week and I didn't understand that the roads did this. And I just ended up in the middle of a cow field
In my car, in You're a cow kidding. Field. No, I had a great little, what, 85 Chevy hatchback Cavalier, you know, and I thought I was cool from California, and I was in a cow pasture, screaming to the top of my lungs.
Okay.
So that was in 92. We didn't have cell phones.
Right.
So no, literally two tractors came out.
They had to pull you out.
Pull me
That's
out.
Hilarious.
Yeah. So okay. That was my welcome to Tennessee story. Okay. But I ended up just falling in love with the town. The people here are amazing. The community's fabulous. So yeah, I never left. I never went back to California. And then unfortunately my mom got she got sick. But we didn't think it was death. Like it wasn't cancer or right. anything. She just got sick and she went to the hospital. So she was going to come home. They right. were going to fix her. Everything was going to be okay. And then 5 days later she was dead. And so then I was also going through a divorce of my husband of 18 years.
During the same time?
With four children. Yes. So the time I needed my mother the most, she left. And so what did I do as a young woman, strong in faith? I blamed God. God can fix anything. God can heal anything. You just slap some oil on that head and say in Jesus' name and they're good, you know? And so I was just very angry at God. Why is my mom dead? Why am I here? How am I going to take care of four kids by myself? You know, kind of what am I going to do?
Yeah.
So it took about 18 months. My dad ran off with the first lady at church that could fold his laundry and make a casserole. Because that's what boys do.
Oh my gosh.
And so now I'm sitting here and I'm like, wow, I've lost my mom and my dad. So I head off back to California and I have my friends there. And I said, I think I'm moving back to California.
Right.
And cussed out God. He's a big dad on the pier. And it was in that moment that I fell to my knees and the Holy Spirit said, are you done yet? And I realized in that moment, I can either continue in my anger, blame, hurt, fear, all the emotions that come with everything that just happened to me in the last 12 months, or I can just pull up my big girl pants and get my butt back to Tennessee and figure out what I'm gonna do. And so when I came back to Knoxville, I decided I was gonna go back to school. I asked God, what am I good at? I'm good at parties, I'm good at food, I'm good at bringing people together. I have this personality. So I knew I could do something with that, but I didn't know.
Okay.
So I went back to school. Because that's what you do when you're 38, 30, oh 35, 38,
really?
Whatever I was. Yeah, I was definitely the oldest person in the classroom. But that's kind of when I found myself again. And I realized that I wasn't done living. I still had a gift. I love hospitality. I love making people happy. I love fabulous, amazing food. I love drinks. I love smiles. And so I think what did it for me is I wanted to create a place that was a ladies' lounge, kind of a place where ladies felt safe, because everywhere in Knoxville has 5 million TVs in your face. Every time you walk in, there's TV, football, baseball, loud, grunchy men at the bar.
Right. What's
you
it,
know,
it's just, a place
for it's guys. Just, it's just a guy place. Mm-hmm. And I was like, girls don't have a cool place to hang out.
Right.
So I knew I wanted to do that element. And then I also knew that, you know, if you just lost your job, if you're a woman and you just found out your husband's having an affair, if you just had a miscarriage, if you are a lady and you need a group of girlfriends, and you, where would you go hang out? There was nowhere in Knoxville that had the girls hang out. So that's why I did the couches that you guys saw earlier.
Right.
I wanted you to understand in this community, when you're mad at God, when you're mad at the world, when you're mad at your boss, when you're whatever, and you're not ready to go back to church or not ready to go be with God yet, but you know that you're loved and forgiven and that you need to find a safe place. That's why I created the bathroom the way that I did. So I don't know if you were able to go in there and see that.
The bathroom it's incredible.
That's the point.
It's incredible. And I'm sure that our field producer will do his magic and they'll put it as B-roll so you can actually see the bathroom. Because when you showed it to me when we walked in, of course, you go to a bathroom and you see maybe a sign here or there, but not all that immense positive messages.
Yeah, that's the point.
You don't see that. And I saw something very interesting. I even asked you about it.
Okay.
I said, What is the angel shot?
Can
you want to tell people on camera what that is?
Oh, so.
Because that's unique.
Right. So because we are a safe space for ladies to be able to hang out, we are also a safe space for internet dating. So we're listed as a place to meet up on the app. That if you feel uncomfortable or you feel like you might be in a situation, or even if you're in an abusive relationship, you can come here and order the angel shot. And the team will make sure that you're exited out the back door and safely taken to your car.
I was brought up by a very strong woman. My mom, I love her to death. She always worked. So I get part of my work ethic from my mother.
Right.
So to have somebody like you that offers this for the community, not only is it welcome, but it's really appreciated. You know,
Thank you. And
to be able to have your world literally crumble apart.
Yeah.
You had the divorce.
Yep.
You had your mom passed away, your dad's gone, you got nothing, and now you have to take care of four kids?
Yeah.
I can't even understand that. I can't comprehend.
And then I decide to open a restaurant?
Right?
Am I crazy?
I mean, I don't understand how even you picked yourself up to be able to even move forward.
God. I didn't do any of it. Without God's blessing, I would not be sitting here with you right now.
Yeah.
God gave me the courage and the purpose and the passion. And so here I am.
Yeah. Well, I mean, people even talk about taking a leap of faith. Well, you took a gigantic leap of faith.
Thank you.
That is, it's unbelievable. And I mean, the space that you have created is special. It really, really is.
Thank you.
And I could tell by all the people that I talk to, they love you.
Thank you.
They absolutely love you. They love being here. And I can completely see how women would feel safe in this space. 100%.
Yeah.
100%. It's outstanding. I mean, I feel very fortunate to not only to have met you, but to have been able to come into your home.
Thank you.
And the food, hey, that's just the bonus. It really
it is.
That's just the bonus.
Yes, my team is amazing. Yeah. I am very blessed that God has given me an amazing group of people to work with. And they're my kids. I love them.
Absolutely. And from what I understand, you also do you Bible study here?
I do.
Okay, so tell me
Bible study at the bar. Who told you about that?
I know things.
Oh, that's so fun. Every Monday. Every Monday. Again, so Jesus told us to go into the world, right? And I took that to heart. It's easy to go to mega churches and big churches and sit in a pew and go home and no one ever knows who you are.
Right.
But when Christ told us to go into the world and love the broken and the hurting, that actually means going to the world. Well, when the world's broken and hurting, sometimes they don't want to go to church, but by golly, they want to go to a bar. So it's the easiest way to share the love of Jesus with people that have no idea how hurting or how upset or just illness, just what the stories that I get of widows, people that, you know, are not quite sure what to do about this cancer diagnosis or whatever. The stories I hear are absolutely amazing. And the only reason I'm able to hear them is because I'm sitting here every night at that bar talking to my community. If I didn't do that, I wouldn't know that. So I tell pastors all the time, I hear you. I hear you in your big churches. Why don't you come sit at my bar, drink your unsweet iced tea, and actually talk to the community.
Right.
You might actually figure out what's going on.
Right.
So.
Right. Well, I mean, when you go to a bar, at least as a guy, right, the bartender is typically the unlicensed psychiatrist.
They are.
That's who you talk to.
Yes.
As a gentleman, you talk to either your barber or your bartender.
Yeah.
Those are the two. Women don't really have that.
That's exactly
they really
right.
They don't.
And I have two beautiful ladies behind my bar. Yes. And, you know, I have that moment where men are not allowed to buy drinks for women at my bar.
Which I thought that is unique. So talk a little bit about that.
So if a gentleman comes in and they want to buy a drink for a lady at the bar, my team asks the lady if she would like a drink from the gentleman from across the bar. And if they say no, then there's no drink. And they tell the gentleman, I'm sorry, but she would not like to accept a drink from you. Again, some ladies, they're not looking to sit at a bar to get hit on.
Right.
they're looking there because they want to read their book, or maybe they want to check their Facebook or just get away from their crazy teenagers that are driving them, right. You know, ah! Right. Who knows why they come to the bar, but I want them to come to the bar because they know they're going to be safe.
Yeah. They just want to have time for themselves.
Yeah. Just that moment. They don't want to talk relax, to anybody, no look at nobody. And that's what they're going to get here. And no man is going to be able to take that away from their experience.
Well, I'm going to tell you that that's exactly what you have here.
Thank you.
What we've experienced here. And again, the food is just a bonus.
Thank you.
Honestly, it's really just a bonus. I've been incredibly impressed. I don't understand how you're putting out the amount and quality of the food within the kitchen. The kitchen is very small. Folks, I'm telling you, it's very, very small. But you have a very talented team.
That's all the more reason. Yeah. So it's kind of like when you have a really huge kitchen, right? You can be dirtier.
Yeah.
You have walk-ins that can let things expire. We get fresh fruit, produce, fresh protein every day. Every day. So you know what's on that plate was delivered within the last 48 hours. That's the difference in a gigantic kitchen and a small kitchen.
Yes.
We're able to do that.
Absolutely.
So.
Absolutely. Well, again, this has been a humongous treat, very, very
Thank
special
you,
for me.
I
so I really appreciate just, again, you inviting me to your home. This is outstanding. This is definitely not the last time I will be here. I promise you that.
Thank
you. Have my word on it.
Well, you're welcome back to Knoxville anytime.
Thank you. I really, really appreciate it. So for the people watching, what would you want the message to be? What would you want to say to them?
We're just a small, local, women-owned business that is trying to serve their community more than just food and drink, but to serve their soul.
Love it. Love it. And where can people find out more about you and your restaurant?
Oh, waterandwineknoxville.com. We're located in Knoxville, right? If you look up the Topgolf,
okay.
Topgolf in Knoxville, we're literally 5 minutes from the Topgolf. We're right around the corner.
Or even better, just look for Water in the Wine. It's not that hard.
Jesus' first miracle.
There you go.
I tell people all the time, don't get mad at me. I did not write the Bible.
Right. There you go. There you go. I love it. I love it. Well, thank you again. Thank you so much.
I appreciate you coming. Thank you so much.
And everybody, you heard it here. You can find them in all the places online. You can also find them on americasbestrestaurants.com. I'm going to return back to having an amazing conversation with Candace and having food. And cheers, everybody. I will tell you this restaurant is 1,000% certified legit. That's it for us. We're gonna sign off. I'm gonna see you guys on the next one. Oh my God, that's so good.